Everyone around me said, don't go to Iran. It's dangerous. Something bad's gonna happen. If you go to the ustravel.gov website, it will say, danger, do not go. All these warnings out there. Americans can't just get up and go to Iran. You need to be on a government-minded tour. But Italians are free to come here and travel wherever. I'm an American citizen, but I have an Italian passport also. I am here as an Italian. There's this group think that goes on. You see what's on TV and you can't help but hold some of that in your head. The reason I'm here, to get this human story. What gets heard on the outside is the politics, but what does not get heard is the voice from the people. We know what's typically shown about Iran.
Going in. It's time. No longer than 2 minutes in Iran, and Kate has reached out.
Hello, everybody. I would like you to visit my hometown.
Oh, cool.
Yes,
cool.
I hope you will like that.
Great, beautiful scenic shots of Tehran. I met very interesting people. It was awesome.
Three, go. Let's go.
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 Hanging out in the mall, I found these very animated, interesting.
I'm Fatima.
On the third day, my camera was stolen. Yeah. Motorcycle thief got me. Came out of nowhere. It was insane. The guy was so good, so professional.
Like this hand went through him. It was just like,
gone. He was on the throttle, had to release his hand, grab my phone, put it in the other hand. Off again. I ran as fast as I could. He was dodging pedestrians. It was like a Hollywood movie for a bit. And it almost had the Hollywood ending because I was gaining on him. He got out to try to get in the traffic, but he couldn't. And the traffic is intense here, so he couldn't just like go onto the road. And so he was trying to maneuver his way, and I was gaining. I was definitely gonna go for his arm and try to bang it out. And right when I was about to reach him, I had a steady cam in my hand. I was gonna throw it and then. The receptionist here, this young woman, Mona, she made up a paper ad. And we're on the hunt right now. This is like a wanted ad. We're gonna find this thing. She's like, that's probably your best way to get the phone because there's a whole black market with the phones here. So someone will steal a phone, they'll sell it to someone else. They might part it out. And if we put these flyers downtown all over the place, then someone might come through.
Mona just got off work. Let me see this flyer.
All right, yeah, we do have this announcement.
Peter, what you doing?
Someone's gonna get work for $500. This is our night tonight, hosting the community. If this thing shows up, then it's a great story.
Lots of peeps in here.
Lots of what?
Peeps.
I don't know what I'm going to do now. I'm sort of waiting for this ghost call tomorrow and someone wanting the reward of $500. It's my fourth day here, but I have zero video and no camera. I woke up in the morning, phone's gone, camera's gone. It's like, man, what am I going to do? Am I going to give up on showing the cool human element to this place? And so, no, I wasn't.
You can only spend the money you come in with because international banking doesn't work here.
All these Iranians coming through via Instagram, asking if they can help. And then I thought of my friend Alex in Kyiv, because I live in Kyiv, Ukraine. It's a 4-hour flight away. Wrote to Alex. Alex, you want to come to Iran? He's like, yeah, I'd like to come there sometime. How about tonight, actually? Because there's a flight going from Kyiv. I think he thought about it for maybe 10, 20 minutes. And then he was in motion.
Hey, Peter, I'm doing some exercise.
Let's get these tickets bought. Cool. He's got them. It's on. He's got the tickets. Now we got to get the phone.
I'm on my way.
Went to my girlfriend's work, went to the apartment, got the money, got the phone.
Living for Tehran.
Two hours of waiting is quite some time, so do you think that's normal though, honestly? Like the screen has changed.
This is Istanbul.
Really?
Gone, look at that. It's all gone.
The baggage, no longer.
Or maybe three.
3 hours. He was on the flight. I know he was on the
guy in the red shirt.
The buddy.
Episodes continue.
Feeling excited.
And so it's back on. It wasn't a failed mission. Could start over. So that's what I did. I started over.
I'm in Iran and I need a VPN to use Apple.
But the VPN is not working.
Because you're not signed in, that won't work either.
Supposed to go on its own. Once you see the screen.
It'll be like 48 hours here. So I couldn't get the VPN, whatever, long ass story. It's been a grind, but that said, the harder it gets, the more I want it.
Or for you to get a code in order to-
We go north, go north.
Yeah.
Look at that, look at those mountains coming right out of the city.
Oh yeah.
What is that?
Mona?
Mona. Off to the mountains near the Caspian Sea to get into
Listen.
I don't know, we might stay at someone's house. I don't know, seriously. No hotel situation or anything lined up here. Mr. Schumacher.
Hello, how are you?
You have to get gray to get the green.
What are you thinking so far of this place?
It looks a little dark and dingy.
random up this mountain, dirt roads through the mud. We're sleeping together, Alex. Is that what you're saying? 243,000 toma. It's like $18 or something, right? Okay, fair enough. Do you have an extra mattress? Because I'm here with my friend and he's a guy. I don't want to sleep with him.
So I'm ahead.
All right, let me get the key.
Do I need to reserve tickets?
Yes.
So what is the next destination for you, my friend?
Caspian Sea. But there's this road along the way that I heard is like a jungle.
Wow.
So my style is just like, let the story develop as it goes along, and who I'm going to meet and run into becomes the story, and the circumstances and the situations I get into becomes the story, and by doing so, it's completely authentic. Like, I can't plan this stuff out.
And this is the Cyrus the Great, and this is the human, the love of human rights.
the love of human rights in his right
hand. In his hands, yes, in his hands.
27 months to make this? Only you?
Only me. Only me, yes.
Wow.
The power of the Iranian nation. Yes.
Quite a fantastically interesting character out here in the middle of nowhere, in the mountains of Iran.
He seemed like this guy that could sleep on the ground and eat, you know, mushrooms and lamb for the next 5 years and just create art. So went north.
Not the Iran that usually comes to mind, but this region north of Tehran. It's totally desert, and then you go over the mountains and you get this. Wow. See you in Tehran.
Yeah. On 5th, November 5th.
Yeah.
NASA just released that people from Ramsar, they can live in Mars better than the others because of the dose of the radiation.
This was this artistic, sort of mystical guy, has a coffee shop there, and wanted to show me around. And so that's how it is in Iran. You run into someone, and all of a sudden, they're saying, hey, come with me and my friends. I want to show you a castle overlooking the Caspian Sea.
One of those, just let the day take you where it wants to take you. It's taking me here on top of a castle.
It's just in the culture to hang out. Well, we had really no agenda.
Check this out, audience. The Iranians absolutely love Instagram. Is that right, or is it anything else?
Yeah, I think it's right for more than 99%. I think that's the only way they can connect to the world and
Instagram.
Share their art. The internet, especially yeah. Instagram.
I was even told it's like the Tinder of Iran. So everything gets done through Instagram.
Goosebumps, that's how much it gets me excited. Because it's green, it's lush. In those clouds are snow-capped mountains. And then behind me is this beauty of the Caspian.
I look at this culture as very well connected. The people really tribe together well. From everyone I've met, they seem to have good friend networks.
One of the very cool things about Iran is you're never really alone.
I love you, Peter.
Let's see. World really opens up when you just sort of go without a plan. Then you end up in a place like this.
Out here in the middle of nowhere, in the mountains of Iran.
Super cool.
No, Mo, you're a trick. It's not a... I don't want to leave. I got to get on a plane in like 2 hours, which I'm not complaining. Going to Esfahan. Esfahan's a completely different world from this. I know that. It's different, almost a different culture, I think. And definitely a different landscape.